Okay, we're gonna do some stuffed peppers. And this is for my beginners, even if you're not a beginner. And that's fine. So let's get started. So in here, grapeseed oil. We're gonna start off with our ground beef. And you can put sausage in here if you want. So many ways you can do it, okay? Again, this is just for the beginner, so we're gonna go easy, okay? And we're gonna give it some seasoning. So then we're gonna use the Badaya, the complete seasoning. And with some basil. And I have the oven on 400. Some parsley. Oregano. Italian seasoning. Remember, you can go heavy with your herbs and your powders. Garlic powder. I like to use a little chive. Then we're going to take a little tomato paste. And we're going to blend it all in now. And you have to remember, you have to drain this meat. Now, just because you put all this stuff in there, don't think you don't have to drain it, because you do. And you can use, like, whatever season you want. I switch up a lot, so. But that's what I'm using for this particular recipe. So we're going to let that brown. Then we'll drain it. It's real simple. But you still want to put the love in there. And I don't own any copyrights to the music, but it's Pandora. Yeah, I know that already, I'm sure. Okay. So. And I have this on medium. This bothers me, I gotta keep doing this. And I know it's gonna keep happening, but I have to keep cleaning it. I have to keep doing it now. Get this nice and chopped up. And the idea of the tomato paste and with all this here and with the Italian seasonings, it is going to give it a good taste with the basil. It's going to really flavor the meat more. Add a good flavor, a richer flavor when you do it this way. And to this, we're going to add some rice. Not yet, though. You know, there's a lot of different ways to do this. Another way I like to do it is put the tiny sausage in there and dice up the bell peppers as well. And then layer it with cheese, with the mozzarella.
And
Then you can put a little sour cream if you want in there and mix it all up. So many different ways you can really make this meal. And I'm gonna do it just a simple way for my beginners. Getting there. Yep. And then once it gets done, make sure that you taste it. Before you put that rice in there, make sure you taste it. That way, in case you need something or you put too much of something in there. But you want to do it before you put the rice in. And you use about maybe 1 cup of rice, maybe 1 cup. You'll know as you go, But you want to start off with a cup. And it has to be cooked, okay? Make sure it's cooked. Got to switch hands. Alright, let me give it a little taste. Make sure we season good. Let's see. I think I'm gonna put a little more complete seasoning on here, okay? I'm gonna put a little flakes of pepper, pepper flakes. Then we're gonna drain it, and then we're gonna add our rice. Yep, that's what it needed. Mm-hmm. That's what it needed, a little more. Okay, I'm going to strain it now. Then we'll add it back. Did I say strain? I meant drain. Wait a minute. There you go. Okay. clean up some of the mess I just made, and now I'm going to turn it down, and we're going to put our rice in. I want to do a little more of the paste, okay? Okay, just a little, just some crushed peppers here. So far, so good. Nice and simple, right? Of course it is. All right. Time for the rice. Okay. I'm using jasmine rice, but it don't matter what kind of rice you use. Where did that come from? Okay. And see, I can tell that I'm going to need some more rice in here, right? There's more meat than there is rice. I want it evenly. So we'll put some more in a minute. Let's just get it mixed up in here. That should do it. And we'll put a little more sauce in, and then we'll stuff our peppers. Again, the oven is on 400. Like, we want to put it in like about 35 to 45 minutes tops. So, we can actually turn the stove off. Because everything is done, we're just incorporating the rice. Huh? Ooh. Oh, that's our baby, huh? Then we are ready to put the mozzarella in the mixture into our peppers. And you know, if you have leftovers, you know what you can always do, roll this up in some cabbage. Right? Put in the freezer until you're ready. And you can roll this up in cabbage and stuff cabbage. Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's move some stuff out the way. We're gonna start the stuff. Give me 1 second. Mm-hmm. clean off this a little bit here. Then we're gonna move over here. I'm gonna bring the peppers out. Okay. Okay. So, before I do anything, I'm gonna take and put a little sauce. And I usually like to take a little sugar and put down in there. A little dab in there. Take the acid out. Just to take the acid out. And then drizzle a little oil. Just a little. It'll cook them a little better when you just put a little bit around the edges. A little drizzle. I like to put a little down the bottom first, just a little, before I stop. Okay. Bring it over, right? Put a little cheese in there. Stuff it really good, okay? Stuff it really good, as deep as you can get it. What do you think so far? Can you do it? Yes, you can. It's very easy. Very simple. Just take your time. Try to stuff, you know, try to really stuff it all the way down to the bottom. Get it in there. Again, I don't own any copyrights to this good music. Look at that. So this is a deep one. You see I broke off a piece of this one by mistake? We're going to stuff it all the way up just the same. Look at that. Stuff it real good. Good flavor in it too, y'all. Good flavor. Okay? I'm going to cover this up for 35 minutes. Then when I take it off, we'll put the cheese on the top and we'll broil it for about the count of 10. Honey, look. I think I can put a little more on one of these. Ooh, that's hot. Okay, and then I'll come back with the finished product after it's done. There'll be nice cheese on the top of it. Again, let me show you. Alright? There you have it. Very simple, my beginners. So you can do this. So I'll see you when it's done. In the kitchen with Cindy too. Like, share, join. And if it's in your heart, you can send me some stars.